Ma, wait a few more minutes for others to join. Okay, ma. Let others join in the meantime. You might have received your first paper, corrected first paper. Second paper, mostly I will be sending this week. In the first paper, what I have seen that the question which is asked, it's a 5-mark question regarding Raoult's law that is was given. You have to define what is Raoult's law. In that case, the question is there. Then. Why certain molecules shows positive deviation? Why certain gases, certain substance gets negative deviation? That has to be explained. Why some of the gases are ideal? Because then the force of attraction exists between the molecules, and in the mixture, how do they exist? That has to be explained, and that has to be supported with the example. See, here one more thing I will tell you. Wherever there is a possibility of giving example, you are supposed to give the example even though it is not being asked. That will support your answer. It's a 5-mark question. It's a 5-mark question. Without the answer, without the supporting example, how will they will provide the mark? That is the one thing I have noted. And second thing, you were asking whether logbook will be provided. That is in this the current question paper they have given logbook and calculator is not available. It's not permitted. So you have to do the calculation. Suppose if you come to thermodynamics and electrochemistry, we have logbook, we have log values. In that particular place, they will give the log value of that number. Then accordingly, using that log value, you can carry out the calculation. That is the way the question will be asked. In that case, then in the case, there is one question we have. Del G related to K value with respect to equilibrium constant. That is, del G is equal to -2.303 nRT log K with K to del G. It is in the first chapter only, in the 11th standard portion only. Even though in the 11th standard portion, now we have with E also we can equate. What is del G? Del G is minus nRT cell. If E cell and K are related, then if they ask you to find out log it, you have to find out the anti-log. They will give in such a way that now here I have understood that. That is, hereafter the question paper will be in such a way that the K value will be easily find it out. Anti-log we may find out. Anti-log of Q 21 bar 00 will come. Then you can write approximately 1 × 10^21. Likewise, log value, k value can be written. Only mostly that is the way it will be there given. For example, k value you are calculating as log k is equal to 21.4765 is there. Suppose. Then in that case, the anti-log of this value should be given. Then only you can calculate it. If they are not given, means in that case they are not providing. Mostly they will give like this. The answer when you after multiplication calculation, the value will be like this most probably. Then log value will be added. Which you can write as 10^-21. Most calculations only directly can be written. Mostly the numericals will be of such type only. That is the expectation. In that case, ma'am, then how you can ask the question? How can we practice? You practice what are the questions there in the textbook? And mostly they will concept will be of same type will be taken. The only the values will be different so that you can make the work easier. That is the way. So keep it in a point that you do the calculation such a way that no calculator, no logbook will be provided. In that case, log 2 value, log 2 by heart it, log 3 by heart it, log 4 need not, log 5 you know, log 5 have to learn, log 6 no, not 7, log 9 you need not. 3 square you can find out, log 9 can be written as 3 square, then 2 into log 3 you can find it out. So these numbers you should know. Log 11 rarely you get it, beyond that it doesn't come. By heart it, so that even they provide it, suppose if they are not provided what to do, you can make your work easier. Otherwise you think on the calculation that where you can simplify the calculation so that you can consume the time less and you get the correct answers. And whenever you write the any values, any arriving at some answers, please check it out at the end whether unit is there. Then your way of writing the calculation and everything. First, you have to write the formula. Substituting the formula that I have not seen, but hereafter I will see. Write the formula. Substituting the formula along with the units, then calculation. At the end, calculation you can do any way of the calculation. But the end of the detail, your result should be there. Result should be along with the unit. When that is there only, you will write. Molecular mass, if they ask molar mass, that should be gram per mole. If you write gram, you won't give the mark. Gram per mole is molar mass. Formula, writing the formula along with the units, substituting the formula along with the units, calculation part, just units are substituted, mark will be there. Then the answer with the unit is required. This is the way of format doing the numericals. That is how I did it. Then definitions, yes, last time definition was very less, so that you all know. Now the message, when we write the feedback only, we will come to know how your explanation is there. Let us see, work on that. This is the thing I noticed in the previous paper. See to that presentation. I forgot the name of the person. One person's paper was very badly written. I asked them write neatly. I told presentation of the paper is also very important. You leave the margin and right hand side, you leave the space for the calculation part. At the center part, you write out. This is the thing I want to say regarding your feedback of your paper one. And sometimes, see, one thing I will tell you, ma'am, you may ask, ma'am, can we strictly take on that? One thing, frankly, I will tell. The questions, what is there to reduce that time, sir has given me a methodology to pick out the questions. So in that case, I will tell you, I see to that, as per CBSE sample paper or previous year's papers, if you see that 3-mark question is there will be a bifurcation of 3-mark is if it is a numerical, it's a 3-mark. Otherwise, it's a statement question is either it will be of definition plus one suggest the following question, justify the statement. Likewise, explanation will be asked. Or either one a question of 3-mark, if it will have bifurcation of 1+1+ also will be there. But in the most of the time, but 2-mark questions rarely you will get the bifurcation. If it's the explanation, bifurcation will be 1+1. Otherwise, definition 2 marks will be there. While picking up the questions, I find out something difficulty. But I see to that hereafter that the bifurcation exact value is correct. For example, Raoul's law when I ask the question. Mostly that question is worth of only of 3 marks. It is not a 5 mark. It is a 5 mark. It's worthy of 3 marks. I will ask mostly in CBSE how they will ask. They will ask, take the one component and they will ask one mixture, they will ask, check it out whether it's a positive or negative deviation. Justify your statement, only 1 mark. You have to write down the course of attraction. If they are definition for Raoul's law, it is 2 marks. And explanation of Raoult's law with positive and negative features 3 marks. Definition is 2 marks and explanation is 3 marks. After explanation 3 marks means each one explanation with the supported should be with the example. See, you also think of if 5 mark question is because how this 5 mark can be bifurcated. Then accordingly content should be there. Think in that way and write down. Think in that way, right? So that is a correct explanation is needed. Some have drawn the graph, some have said drawing the graph is required, not required. If you are drawing the graph, x-axis, y-axis should be said. What are the lines? Everything has to be explained. If you are simply drawing the graph, it is not being given. Think that unknown teacher is writing, correcting the paper. If unknown teacher, if the teacher doesn't know the subject, is correcting the paper, what are the explanation you have to give? That way your paper should be. I should not search for the answer. Everything should be logically written. That way the paper should be. See to that, that next time your paper is a better one. And Harini, you have done the first question itself wrong. Why? If that is being reduced, the mark would have been better. And see to that, that even after the giving the worksheet only is being that, go through the content better and write up the take up the test. Next, let us go. This is now. Next, we have to go for the block. D-block, what are the possible questions we can take it up? First page we have, why zinc, cadmium, mercury, what is the definition for transition elements? This is zinc, cadmium, mercury are called as D-block elements. D-block means the valence electrons enter into the d orbital. Yes, it's a D-block elements, but we don't call that as a transition elements. What is the definition for transition elements? Elements either in the ground state or in any one of the state, any one of their excited state have unpaired electrons in the d orbital, then they are called as a transition metals. Metals either in the ground state or in any one of their excited state have unpaired electrons in the d orbital, we call as a transition elements. They are not called as a transition element. Yes, zinc, ground state, Zn2+3d10, 4s2. Similarly, it is 3d10 means it is 4d10. This is 5d10. Here, even in the higher oxidation state, they don't have unpaired electrons in the d orbital. So we don't call them as a transition elements. That is the first statement. Then, first row of d block elements should be known very clearly so that it says your pen. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. Then there is the first question. The same thing only, it is being repeated. Let us go for the page. In test question, everything should be learned. Silver atom has completely filled d orbitals in its ground state. How can say it's a transition metal? Because silver shows +1 and also +2. +2 is unstable, +1 is stable, but it also shows +2. In +2, it has unpaired electrons in the d orbital, so it's a transition metal. Next, if I go to atomization, the amount of energy required to break the metal-metal bond to make into corresponding atoms is called atomization. Upper greater the number of unpaired electrons in the d orbital, metal-metal bonding becomes stronger and greater the atomization. When I move along the period till manganese, the unpaired electrons increases. So atomization increases. After manganese, what happens? Unpaired electron decreases. Unpaired electrons, enthalpy of atomization decreases. Next is the same thing is explanation for melting and boiling point. Till chromium, but actually we expect that till manganese melting point will increase. After manganese will decrease. That is the way we expect it. Melting point increases till chromium. Manganese take a dip, then only then further decreases then. Why? This dip is of manganese is because since it has manganese. This manganese, it is D5 configuration, D5 4s2. Since it has unpaired electrons in the DRB, it doesn't want this unpaired half-filled DRB to be get disturbed. So involvement of bonding in manganese atom is lesser. So metal bundle bonding is weaker. So melting point of manganese is lesser. Then still chromium, the number of unpaired electrons increases. Metal-metal bonding is higher. So melting point increases. That you have to keep in mind. But mostly they don't ask, but suppose now competitive exam pattern, the question has come, so it may come, but there is very near secrecy. Enthalpy atomization increases. Why enthalpy atomization increases? Then, and then after that decreases. Why? It's because of unpaired electrons in the d orbital. Increases, then decreases. Unpaired electrons, only the unpaired electrons in the d orbital involves in metal-metal bonding. Greater the number of electrons, greater the bond formed between the atoms. Stronger the force of attraction. That's the thing. Next, when we talk about atomic size and Then I move down the shin. When I move down the group, I expect that atomic radius should increase. But I find out that if there is an increase for 3D series, we took a 4D series, 5D series, and 60D series, we say that, because there are four rows of it. In this four row, here you have lanthanides, here you get that actinides in that field. When I move from here, size of the atom increases, the number of shells increases. When I come over here, after lanthanides, if I see hafnium and zirconium, this comes. When I expect that the zirconium to hafnium, when it comes, it should increase, I should expect it. But it, I'm not seeing the increase because hafnium size is almost the same as zirconium. Right? Hafnium comes after lanthanides. So hafnium experience lanthanoid contraction. What is lanthanoid contraction? The regular, you can make the definition very simple, regular decrease in the atomic size of lanthanoids. Due to increasing lanthanides, well understood, which orbital, 4D orbital comes, 4F orbital comes, that understood. The regular decrease in the atomic size of lanthanoids with increase in atomic number is called as lanthanoid contraction. Because 4F orbital is a partially, partially pulling the electron this way, pulling this electron towards the nucleus. Whereas the number of shells, increase in the number of shells makes the size of the atom bigger. Both are acting opposite to each other. So what happens? There is a slight decrease in the size of the atom. That is the reason hafnium shows smaller in size. So when the smaller in size, if you see that this is almost the same. But when I see the graph, that only the question asks, 4D, this is 4D series, atomic size of 5D series should be greater than 4D series. But in the graph, we say that the 5D series is similar to that of 4D series. Why? Because of lanthanide contraction. You need not explain what is lanthanide. Because of lanthanide contraction, you will get the mark. Understand? Here you have actinide contraction, which is more pronounced. Actinide and lanthanide. Actinide contraction is more pronounced than lanthanide contraction. Why? Because it is 5F orbital. Poor shielding of 5F orbital is very higher than the 4F orbital. Actinide contraction is more pronounced than lanthanide contraction. Ma'am, these are not there, you can say that, but this already we are doing in the general principle. So you have to, when you are going into detail, but you should know this. So then, therefore, so when I move down, you are not seeing that much increase as we are seeing in S block and P block. One is because of lanthanide contraction, another is because of actinide contraction. Next, the enthalpy, in the series, enthalpy of nations is the lowest because it does not have unpaired constant. We can, number of, there is just a, you should write zinc Y, zinc outer electron configuration is 3D10 porous, so no unpaired electrons in the D orbital, so metal-metal bonding is weaker, so melting point is less. That is the thing you have to write. You have to write, there are no unpaired electrons in the D orbital. If you tell that, we won't give the mark. You have to write zinc, outer electronic configuration of zinc is 3D10 porous, so no unpaired electrons in the D orbital, so metal-metal bonding is weaker. That explanation makes it perfect. Then why do the transition elements exhibit higher enthalpy of atomization? Because the why atomization here metal transition metals have metal-metal bonding. Metal-metal bonding is due to presence of unpaired electrons in the d orbital. Greater the number of unpaired electrons in the d orbital, greater, stronger the bond. Okay, stronger the bond. So metal-metal bonding is stronger. Say enthalpy of transition metals is higher than transport. They are asking of other two metals. They are not talking of atomization on a longer period. The enthalpy of atomization of transition metal is higher than any other metals in the S block and the P block. Why? Larger the number of unpaired electrons in the D orbital, stronger the metal-metal bonding, so enthalpy of atomization is higher. Next, ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy of these elements or the first row series is not regular. Why? Why? Because why there is a statement, by heart the statement, and because it's often asked question. Why? Because when I remove the electron from the S orbital, there is a reorganization energy arises because there is a already in the chromium and copper we can see there is a shift is taking place. Therefore, reorganization energy takes place, and along with the reorganization, there is an exchange of energy takes place in the metal atom. Due to the transfer of electron from S to D. That is a reason we are having that the transition metals of the first series do not show regular decrease in the ionization enthalpy. Why? Electronic configuration is not regular. And there is a, once the electron is removed, there is a reorganization energy takes place which to make it more stable. Apparently, exchange energy also add up. There are different energies being involved in that. So only ionization enthalpy of first group elements are not regular. Write down the definition as I told. Then if they ask any other thing, why ionization enthalpy of chromium 2 plus, compare chromium 2 plus, Mn 2 plus, what is I, which will have ionization enthalpy here? Very simple, why don't they, if they, I'm telling this as a simple. If any question began, chromium and manganese, you know very well, even though some other element is given, check out the element electronic configuration. Without electronic configuration, don't compare the answer. Chromium, no, you know 3D5, 4S1, it is 3D4. Then manganese, what is it? 3D5. It is half field stable configuration. Removal of electron is very difficult. So ionization enthalpy of manganese, Mn 2 plus is higher. Mn, BCr 2 plus is ready to lose one electron. It is 3D4. Ready to lose electron to attain the 3D, that is T2G, half field stable configuration, ready to lose. So ionization enthalpy is lesser. When they ask to compare, both has to be justified. If they ask why manganese has ionization, Mn2 plus has ionization enthalpy greater than Cr2 plus, the half field stable configuration, removal of electron is very difficult. But in chromium 3D4, removal of one electron, ready to lose one electron to attain the stable T2G configuration. So ionization enthalpy, this is lesser, this is higher. You have to compare, write both of them. If you write this is why manganese ionization enthalpy is higher than Mn2 plus is higher than Cr2 plus, if I tell half will be orbital configuration, so greater means I will not give mark. Tanga, you have to write manganese out electronic configuration of Mn2 plus is 3D5, half will stable configuration, removal of electron is very difficult. Whereas here, out electronic configuration 3D4, removal of one electron will lead to the stable 3D T2G configuration, so ready to lose electron. Why I'm telling, I will tell you. Suppose when I am seeing such transfers very elaborately, neatly written without a mistake, even some of the mistakes purposely done by you, by unknown effect, can be overlooked. Why? When I have this detail, I have a better feeling of you people, that is when I correct it, so that the child knows well, very clearly explain that explanation. Then automatically my correction of the other questions will take that much, will plus and more will happen, so that the correction will be taken in a different way. Everything is based on move only. That is okay, ma'am. Then you can say that your teacher is partial. It is not a partial. That is, I don't know the name of the child, sir. We are not partial. I'm talking about the mood, how you are changing your mood. Like this, that happens for the people also. We expect that people should be balanced to correct it. Yes, we do it. I'm not the fact, no teacher is against the student's mark, student's performance. No teacher is against. But suppose if you see the end of the result, now you will find difference between yourself and the person, low, slow learner, average student, you find large difference. Many after you get the result, you will see that the difference between you and the average learner or mediocre or will be very less. Why? Because it's because of the correction only. Moderation is being done and everything. Many unwanted things are happening nowadays. Earlier it was not there. Nowadays it's happening. But so the differences becoming between the two persons becomes very low. Competition becomes very high there. When the paper is there, getting high marks is not now easier. That is getting 80, above 80 in the subject is easier. But beyond, above 80, if you have to sustain this, you have the answer should be pakka, then only you'll get it. See to that give the correct explanation. If I ask only manganese ionization enthalpy, manganese is very high. If I ask, you can talk about only manganese. When I compare this means you have to address both things, that you have to keep in mind. So any element when they are asking, compare the, write down the outer electronic, okay? Don't write 3D4, 3D5, I will not give the mark. 3D4, 3D5, what does it mean? Outer electronic configuration of chromium, outer electronic configuration of manganese. Now time is not there enough. Don't say, you have in chemistry, you will have enough time. Organic part will consume very less mark because most of the organic questions are complete the reaction, very simple. So what are the time you are saving from organic can be utilized for inorganic chemistry. So far none of the students have told you they are not have enough time to complete the chemistry paper. No, so far nobody at all. There will be minimum 45 minutes, 1 hour you will get it. Even though you write very slowly, the enough time also, there will be half an hour to 45 minutes, you will have enough time in the time. So that is the thing. And the extra ionization enthalpy. So anything question you are being asked means compare the electronic configuration of that ion and tell the answer. Next, oxidation state we can talk about. What is oxidation state? That is the maximum oxidation state is shown by manganese. Why? Maximum number of unpaired electrons in the d orbital. That is the thing. then you know that this often asked question, elements of lower oxidation state is said to be more basic, elements of higher oxidation state is said to be more acidic. For example, if I take Mn2+, Mn4+, this is more acidic, this is less acidic. Why? Electron deficiency is more, greater tendency to attack the electron. Electron acceptor is acidic, electron donor is basic. Tendency, both have an electron deficient, tendency to accept the electron only. But here is accepting the electron is more than this. So we say this is more acidic than this. This is applicable for even for pre-block polymers. Then this question often asked, if for example, electrode potential of Cu2+ reduced Cu is positive. Whereas for the first row of transition metals, for first row of transition any metal 2+ bar metal, it is always negative for everyone. For all the metals is negative, but only for copper it is positive. That's the question often asked. Why? The electro potential is a sum of sublimation enthalpy, sublimation enthalpy, hydration enthalpy, ionization enthalpy, and hydration enthalpy. Electro potential is calculated from sum of sublimation enthalpy, ionization enthalpy, and hydration enthalpy. These are in some other metals. If I find it out, nickel equals right. Nickel, this is negative. You can say that because D chain, Mn2+ is metal is ready to move from Mn2+ is a stable configuration, 3D configuration, so ready to lose two electrons. So E naught potential is negative, you can say. But if I take cobalt under, you cannot talk about the electronic configuration. Electronic stability of electronic configuration you cannot talk about, because cobalt electronic configuration is 3D7, it is not stable. Then which makes that? Cobalt ion is smaller, hydration enthalpy is more. Upper more hydration enthalpy is negative. More negative compensates the ionization enthalpy and sublimation enthalpy. So E naught value is lesser. When there is a stability of electronic configuration, you talk about the stability of electronic configuration. If the stability of electronic configuration is not there, then in those cases, which one pays hydration enthalpy? But if I take copper, ma'am, you can say cobalt comes, then only copper comes. Ma'am, copper is very smaller than cobalt. Its hydration enthalpy will be higher. No, how do you say? Yes, hydration enthalpy of copper is greater than cobalt. But there is some two more things. When the size becomes smaller and smaller, sublimation enthalpy, ionization enthalpy also increasing. So this, whatever the energy you are getting, you are not able to compensate this sum. But we are able to compensate in cobalt. That you have to keep in mind. Understand or not? So what is the hydration enthalpy of copper is more negative, but even though it is more negative, it is not able to compensate the sum of sublimation enthalpy and ionization enthalpy. Hence, cannot compensate. This is low negative, this is more positive. So the value is positive. That's the reason. Very simple, you can explain it. Next, that is same as, that is if I ask, for example, suppose E naught vanadium 3+ vanadium will be E naught chromium 3+ chromium. Whose E naught value will be lesser? Whose that you can afford it? I'm not giving the value. Whose E naught value will be lesser or higher? How can you justify? Very simple. Chromium 3+, because electro potential I have to talk in terms of reduction. So B. Upper B plus, okay, scandium, titanium, vanadium. 3D3, 4S2. 3D3 means, what is the 3D3 means? It is in 3D2, understand? If I take chromium, chromium is Cr3+ plus 3 electron gives Cr3. Chromium is Cr3+ means chromium is 3D5, 4S1. 3D3 means 3D3+, 3+ means it is 3D3. Yes, 3D3. Here, 3D2 plus 3D3+. Taking 3 electrons and attaining the stable state. Whose E naught value will be more, this E naught value will be more negative than this. Why? I'll tell you. Here 3D2, it is unstable configuration. So ready to accept the electron to try to make it stable. But Cr3+ is a T2G configuration, stable T2G, accepting that electron is lesser. So compared to this E naught value, there is tendency to accept the electron of Cr3+ is lesser compared to that of V3+. That you have to take it out. If for example, V3+, V2+, I'm taking Cr2+. 3D+ means by accepting one electron, it becomes 3D3.
By accepting the electron, it becomes 3d4. So whose E naught value will be more? E naught value will be, for this, it is E naught value will be more than this. Why? Because it is ready to accept the electron to move from unstable to stable state. But here it's already in stable T2G configuration. So it will not accept the electron. The accepting of electron to form, accepting the electron of Cr3+ to accept the electron is lesser. Lesser the electron, accepting the electron is lesser means its E naught value will be negative, low. This E naught value will be higher, greater tendency to accept the electron. Because it's moving from unstable to stable. So E naught value of this will be higher. E naught value of this will be lower. Ma'am, if they are given different metals, different ions, how do I know? Go by reduction potential only they will give. In CBSE, they will talk regarding only reduction potential. They won't talk about oxidation potential. Upper reduction potential are ready to accept. Check out whether they are moving from stable to unstable. Stable to unstable na, not preferred. Unstable to stable na, preferred. It is unstable to stable, preferred. So it's preferred. The reaction is ready to undergo. So E naught value will be higher. It is not ready to go. E naught value will be lesser. That way I can predict it. I need not know the value. If I know the ion, I can predict it. So that way you predict, try to predict the things. Learn that way. So that any objective questions being asked, you will be able to do it. Strengths and stability of higher oxidation state. Higher oxidation state of transition metals are done by only by oxygen and fluorine. Because of small size, high electronegativity, that is the reason. And high bond dissociation enthalpy. Because of small size, high electronegativity, and the bond form between the metal atom and the anion is found to be very strong, the high bond dissociation enthalpy. Because of these three natures, we say that this stabilizes the metal atoms. Higher oxidation state of metal atoms are stabilized by these anions. But the number of compounds, stabilization is done among these two. Stabilization is highly done by oxygen compared to fluorine. Both are smaller in size, more electronegative. The bond formed is of high bond dissociation enthalpy involved. So both are stabilizing the higher oxidation state of transition metals. But among the two, which one does more oxygen? Why? Because its ability to form pi bond. That's the reason. Next, there's an interest question is given. That is why oxidizing power increases. Higher the oxidation state, higher the oxidizing power, that you know. Among the D-block elements, you know, potassium permanganate acts as a very good oxidizing agent because its oxidation state is plus 1. Oxidizing agent என்ன பண்ணும் it get reduced. அப்ப கேமனோபோர் is a plus 7 oxidation state. It can act only as an oxidizing agent. It's a higher oxidation. It can go down only. So it acts as an oxidizing agent. It cannot act as a reducing agent. Why? Reducing agent, it should get oxidized. That is the maximum oxidation state. Plus 7 is the maximum oxidation state. Beyond that, it cannot go up. So only KMnO4 acts as an oxidizing agent. If an oxidizing agent of a property can be, of a substance can be determined from its oxidation. Higher the oxidation state, higher the oxidizing power. That way you can account. Chemical reactivity of and the E naught values, we say that. E naught values, since the E naught value is the sum of ionization, is calculated from sum of ionization enthalpy, sublimation enthalpy, and ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy of a 3D series. Just a minute, battery slow. Just a switch on. That is, ionization enthalpy of the first, ionization enthalpy is not regular. Therefore, ionization enthalpy is not regular, means then E naught value also will not be regular. That is the reason. Then why is the E naught value of Mn3+, the same way, Mn3+, bar, Mn2+, is much more positive than that of Cr3+, by Cr2+. Then, Fe3+, plus Fe2+, because it is moving from unstable to stable state. If you write that, we won't give the mark. Please, because we know that, Mn3+ is moving from unstable to stable, so E naught value is positive, more preferred. If Cr3+, it is stable to unstable, stable to unstable, so less preferred, so E naught value is lesser. If you write, I will not give the mark, so sorry. You have to write Mn3+, it is what configuration? It is D4 configuration, it is D5 configuration, outer electron configuration. So it's moving from unstable to, by taking one electron, it's moving from unstable to Mn3+, Yes, taking one electron to move it from unstable to stable stable half filled d5 configuration. So E naught value is positive, more preferred. So E naught value is positive. Here it is d3 t2g configuration. You are right, d4. It is moving from stable to unstable. So not preferred. So E naught value is lesser. That explanation should be there regarding electron configuration. Understand the concept. Then this is the thing. But if anything is being given, go with electronic configuration so that you won't need worry about that. E naught value. Next is which is the that I have no. What which is a stronger reducing agent? Cr 2 plus. This is argon asthma. Fe 2 plus Y. We think that Cr 2 plus is reducing agent. It get oxidized. The oxidation state of Cr 2 plus, which is a stronger reducing agent. Apa it get oxidized. It converts to Cr 3 plus. Fe 2 plus is converted to Fe 3 plus. It is moving from unstable to stable. This also moving from unstable to stable. And I in the configuration is T2G configuration. இங்க பார்த்தனா டிபை கான்பிகரேஷன் we think the டிபை கான்பிகரேஷன் is most stable but actually most of the chemical reactions take place in aqueous form and this is a smaller ion get this is cr3+ get more hydrated because of the hydration enthalpy cr3+ is acting cr2+ acts as a very good releasing agent in aqueous solution mostly reaction will take place in aqueous solution so only cr2+ is acting as very good releasing agent in aqueous solution Then magnetic moment is due to the presence of unpaired electrons in the d orbital. Then it can be calculated. Magnetic property is due to the presence of unpaired electrons. Paramagnetic, diamagnetic, magnetic property. Magnetic moment now is calculated from the number of unpaired electrons. It is calculated by n of n two plus two Bohr monomer. N is the number of unpaired electrons. Understand? Suppose if they will ask you to calculate, means you calculate, but they never ask to calculate it. But suppose Bohr magnet magnetic moment of an ion is 3.5 Bohr magneton. Talk about the magnetic property. Now the 3 itself tells you, the whole number tells you it contains three unpaired electrons in the d orbital. Understand? Paramagnetic effect. You can find out the number of unpaired electrons from the magnetic moment. Bohr magneton kuduttaana, adha whole number will tell you the number of unpaired electrons. You need not calculate it and waste your time. 4.7, 4.9 also approximately 5 in solada. 4.9 they give means you have to write only 4 unpaired electrons. 4.7, 4 unpaired electrons. 3.9, 3 unpaired electrons. What is the value given? Based on that value, you write down the whole number, check out the whole number. For that, you write down the unpaired electrons. Then you can know from the unpaired electrons, you can, the magnetic moment will come only unpaired electrons. Unpaired electrons, then you can determine how many unpaired electrons are there. That can be found out. Next, formation of colored ions. What is the formation of colored ions? The formation of colored ions due to presence of, you are right, why copper 2 plus is colored? Copper 2 plus is colored now, what electronic configuration is that? 3d10, 4s1, not copper. Copper 2 plus means is 3d9 is colored because of a presence of unpaired electrons in the d orbital, which leads to dd transition. Hence, the compounds are colored. Because of unpaired electrons in the d orbital material, you know, unpaired electrons in the d orbital, which leads to dd transition. Dd transition falls in the visible region, so only they are colored, not only the presence of unpaired electrons. Dd transition, because the dd transition energy required is very, it falls in the visible region, so only they are colored. That is the reason you are right. Next, formation of complex compounds. Why this d block elements forms a complex compounds? Why? Small size, high charge, availability of vacant d orbital. Small size, high charge, because if you take the charge Cr2 plus, but the Cr 3 plus, the charge is higher, metallic charge is higher, and availability of d orbital, now we won't give availability of vacant d orbital, because metal complex is vacant d orbital, ligand has to provide the electron, so the orbital should be vacant to accept the electron. So small size, high charge, and availability of vacant d orbital is the reason for the formation of complex compounds. Catalytic property, because of its catalytic variable oxidation state. Why d block elements acts as a very good catalyst? Because of d block elements shows variable oxidation state. Upon variable oxidation state, they can combine with elements according to the elements, it can show various compound formation. So they are acting as a catalyst because of its ability to form variable oxidation state. D block elements acts as a very good catalyst. Formation of interstitial compounds. Yeah, now these metal compounds exist in a crystal lattice. appa crystal lattice there however the atoms are arranged in the crystal there will be some space this interstitial space are being occupied by smaller atoms like nitrogen hydrogen so these compounds are form interstitial compounds because this deep layer primers are exist in the form of a crystal lattice however the crystal lattice are there will be some interstitial space available for smaller atoms to get trapped so they are able to form interstitial compounds alloy formation these deep layer primers even though there is a regular decrease in the atomic size when they move along the period but the decrease is said to be very very smaller so since the deep layer primers are almost the same size they are ready to form alloys that is the reason for the alloy formation next year or often asked question there is a one question explain why cu plus is unstable in aqueous solution often asked cu plus is unstable in aqueous solution because the hydration enthalpy of cu plus makes the cu2 plus hydration enthalpy is higher hydration enthalpy of cu2 plus is higher than cu plus in a more charged more hydrated hydration enthalpy of Cu2 plus is very higher the energy given out is utilized to remove the electron from Cu plus so Cu2 plus is stable the question is asked about Cu plus but we are talking about Cu2 plus that also you understand they are asking Cu plus is unstable why Cu2 plus is, there is some other ion is stable so what happens Cu plus is stable because the more hydration enthalpy of Cu2 plus utilized for the removal of ionization enthalpy of Cu plus hydration enthalpy Cu plus so Cu plus is unstable in aqueous solution often asked question next year the other things are not asked next year the page is removed we don't have if when I talk about this transition elements Lamprey contraction will be asked in oxidation state I will talk about the oxidation state in that oxidation state plus 3 is the common oxidation state of lanthanoids plus 3 is that common oxidation state of lanthanoids but some of the elements shows plus 2 and plus 4 is there plus 2 and plus 4 are there why this is be this plus 2 and plus 4 due to the extra stability that arises due to f0 f7 and f14 configuration that you have to talk about why some of the compounds shows plus 2 and plus 4 the extra stability arises due to extra stability arises due to F0, F7 or F14. Plus 4 means F7 configuration. Plus 2 means either it may be of F0, cerium 4+. Cerium 4 plus, it is F0 configuration. So they will ask, so you, they, in that case, if they ask like this, plus 2 and plus 4, if they ask why they show plus 2 and plus 4, due to the extra stability arises due to F0, F7, F14 configuration. So the metal atoms are existing plus 2 and plus 4. That is one question asked. Next, you have to talk about cerium 4 plus. This is often asked. Cerium 4 plus is possible. Yeah, cerium 4 plus, what are configuration? F0 configuration. So F0 configuration is stable. So Cu 4 plus is available. Then Cu 4 plus converts ready to Cu 3 plus. Why? The common oxidation of lanthanides is Cu 3 plus. So ready to accept one electron to form. So it acts as a very good. Oxidizing agent may not, it get easily reduced. Understand? So why is Cu4 plus acts as a very good oxidizing agent? Because the common oxidation state of lanthanides is plus 3. So it ready to convert into a plus 3 state by accepting the electron. So it acts as a very good oxidizing agent. Next is europium and ytterbium. They will ask europium Eu2 plus, ytterbium 2 plus. They show. Europium, ytterbium are possible. Why? Europium is F7, ytterbium is F14 configuration. That you should know. Europium is F7 configuration, ytterbium is F14 configuration. Extra stability that arises. This is ytterbium is acting as a very good reductant. Why it is acting as a very good reductant? Because if this is common oxidation state of lanthanides is plus 3, so ytterbium ready to lose one electron to form ytterbium 3 plus. So it acts as a very good reductant, reducing agent. Reduce very easily to oxidize. That is the real concern. This is a question that we can ask it. But if they ask specifically why Cu4 plus is possible, then you write only F0 because of F7, F14, and all you should not write. Keep that in mind. If they ask the question that lamp color shows only common oxidation state plus 3, but some of the lamp color shows plus 2 and plus 4, means you can write due to excitability arises due to F0, F7, F14. But if they specify cerium 4 plus, that is F0 configuration, ytterbium F14 configuration, europium F7, specifically they ask, you have to write that particular configuration. You cannot blindly write everything. Then the other things are normal. Then you can say that why this transition, but have a look of the electronic configuration of lanthanides, because now your objective questions are coming higher and portions are being reduced. So they will be there to take the questions. So they will concentrate all those things also. So have a look on the electronic configuration of lanthanides. Next day, lanthanides also shows lanthanide ion compounds also said to be colored. Why they are colored? Because of presence of unpaired electrons in the f orbital, which leads to f up transition. Energy difference again forcing the residual result. So only f block elements are also colored. Compounds also colored. Other chemical reactions are not there. Actinides we don't have. Next day, coordination compounds. In coordination compounds, the question often asks this. They, for example, they may say that if it is COCl3.NS3 is there, that is COCl3 5NS3 is there. If I am treating with silver nitrate, I am getting off two moles of AgCl is given out. What will be the structure? What will be the structure? 2 moles of AgCl is produced here. Upper that tells you that Cl, two chlorine atoms can be ionizable. Upper ionizable, they are ionizable compounds are outside. Non-ionizable compounds are inside the coordination sphere. Upper cobalt, Cl is gone. Upper Cl, upper remaining is NS3-5. You should know that cobalt and shows only of tachycardic compression. So one Cl2 goes off, remaining 5-3-1 Cl, that information you need. Cl2, 2-chlorine, that is the thing. Then how do you write down? When I write down, that how am I to write down the ligands? Have I written it correctly? No, it's wrong. Why? The ligands should be arranged in the alphabetical order. Upper how are you to write? CO, NS3, PiCl, then Cl2. This is the correct way of writing it. Then how am I to write down the IUPAC name? Then I ask the same way, cation should be named first followed by the anion. Here cation, when the here cation is having the square bracket, then I have to name the ligands, then I have to go for the metal atom. When I'm naming the ligands, then I have to follow the alphabetical order. Pentaamine. Amine here, ammonia, A-M-M-I-N-E, that you have to keep in mind. Pentaamine, chlorido, cobalt, then the metal atom, you have to write down the oxidation state. Here, X, this is a neutral, it is minus 1. This charge comes here, so it is plus 2. Therefore, X is equal to 3. Cobalt 3, chloride. This is the way we write it out. Then, this type of question often asks, be careful. That is the thing. Then when I write the ambidentate ligand, we know that ambidentate ligand. Ambidentate ligand means CN is called as an ambidentate. NO2 called as an ambidentate. CN is called as CN is an ambidentate. When the monodentate ligand can be bonded to the metal atom through two different atoms, we call as an ambidentate ligand. So you have a look on that. Homolytic oxidation number, you know that oxidation number, for example, you have to keep in mind that I have this CO5 or any metal bonded to a carbon monoxide, this metal atom is in zero oxidation state, that you should know. Nickel, NiCO4, this is nickel, it is zero oxidation. And the metal atom is bonded to the carbon monoxide, it is a zero oxidation state here. Then, what I have to tell that this is regarding, then isomerism you don't have. Then, isomerism you don't have. Valence bond theory, they will ask, regarding valence bond theory only, they will ask, write down the electronic configuration. Then, water, mostly water, halogen. Mostly water, halogen, EN, carbon monoxide, ammonia, this and that would be there. Among the halogens, among the ligands given to us, these two are considered as a weaker ligand. Other things are considered as a stronger ligands. So here electron pairing takes place. Here no electron pairing takes place. That you have to keep in mind. One more thing I want to tell, chromium always will be a top tachycardic compressor. Thank you. அப்ப குரோமியம் இஸ் an octahedral complex ஆ அப்ப குரோமியம் octahedral complexஸ் பாத்தீனா ஆல்வேஸ் இட் இஸ் will be a plus 3 oxidation state if it is a stronger ligand or weaker ligand pairing cannot take place because the possible oxidation state of octahedral is either sp3d2 or d2sp3 அப்ப d இது வந்து கே பாத்தீனா குரோமியம்க்கு d3 னா i can write only like this here i cannot pair so they always whether it's a weaker ligand or a stronger ligand chromium complex will be always of paramagnetic high paramagnetic property keep in mind apa nickel complexes in paathina nickel h2o 6 2+ or ni ammonia with ammonia 6 2+ it is a stronger ligand here weaker ligand stronger or weaker whatever may be the ligand is there because it will be a 3d8 ah apo you will have one I think 8 ah apo enna 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 for nickel for ammonia is a stronger ligand I will pair up but this will not be involved only one d orbital is not available for me I need two d orbital so in that case the no pairing takes place here no pairing will take place apo enna it always undergoes sp3 outer spin complex only this chromium whatever the ligand it has but it will be a inner spin low spin complexes here it will be a high spin complexes low spin inner d orbital high spin outer d orbital always will be a high spin complexes keep that in mind apa next question nickel vandu tetrahedral na if it is a nickel tetrahedral means according to the ligand it will take place but is not octahedral complex octahedral complex of nickel are always high spin complexes chromium always of low spin complexes high spin outer d orbital involved inner spin complex and inner low spin complex inner d orbital involved that you have to check it out this is the open question that you have to keep in mind other things you get bad that is not a problem that you have to that is there in your CBSE that you have to keep in mind and when it is bonded to carbon monoxide nickel is in zero oxidation state for example here nickel is in zero oxidation it's a strongest ligand that you have to keep in mind and talk about the magnetic property check it out they ask mostly they give a ligand and they ask to find it out magnetic property structure I basis and I want to tell about geometry and shape what is geometry and shape means geometry is the thing what you are getting from hybridization shape is because here in coordination compass in coordination compass geometry and shape almost remains the same in coordination compass but if I talk SF4 you are studying of P-block SF4 we'll talk about geometry is trigonal bipyramidal geometry is trigonal bipyramidal but shape is seesaw shape here in the case of nickel compass because we don't have a lone pair as we have here in that compound in a coordination compound geometry and shape both remains the same but in the ordinary compound geometry and shape are not the same they are different here geometry when I talk about geometry what you are getting from hybridization is geometry what we are arising from the bonded bonds that is bonded electrons orbital of bonded electrons give the shape for example if I take ammonia this is bonded electrons this is non bonded electrons non bonded electrons will not give a shape to the molecule only bonded electrons give the shape to the molecule so this is a pyramidal shape this will not give a shape but what geometry is a tetrahedral geometry ana in a coordination compass there is no we don't have a lone pair in the coordination compass we have not studied lone pair in the coordination compass so in this compass geometry and shape are same in the coordination compass whereas here geometry and shape are different for example if I take Fe F2 if I take shape is linear geometry is trigonal bipyramidal shape so you have to talk about the hybridization because it undergoes sp3d2 hybridization sp3d hybridization so trigonal bipyramidal shape what I get it from the hybridization is the geometry what I get it from the bonded electrons is the shape but in the coordination compass geometry and shape remains the same okay but I want to inform you next year crystal phase theory the structure has to be there that diagram has to be you should know you have to learn and there is a question may be asked how much energy is decreased how much energy is increased that you have to know that is 2/π del naught here 3/π del naught that is for That is here when the P2G left EG. Understand? 2 by pi del naught, this and that you have to know. And del naught is lesser than del T, that you, del naught is greater than del T, that you should know. And understand, because energy difference is lesser, that only we know. Next year, next year, next year, next year. No, del T is greater than del naught. So only always del T, since the energy difference between del T, yes, sorry, T2, this is for tetrahedral compressors. Since this energy difference is very, very high, always third electron goes for pyrene. So only we are having low spin complexes. That is the statement is there. The orbital splitting energies are not sufficiently large for forcing pyrene, and therefore low spin configurations are rarely observed. Sorry, ma'am. Del naught is greater than del T only. Sorry. Del naught is greater than del T only. Since del T is lesser, yes, correct. I'm sorry. Del T is lesser, 1, 2, this way, then only pyrene. So high spin complexes are more in case of tetrahedral complex. Why? Del T is smaller. Since del T is smaller, del T is smaller than pyrene energy. So if they want to go for pyrene, yeah, some amount of energy has to be given. Since del T is lesser, they are not going for pyrene, they go higher. So high spin complexes are higher in tetrahedral complex. Low spin complexes are very rare. Rarely observed. That is the reason. Correct. Sorry. Del naught is greater than del T. What is del T is equal to? They are given 4 by 9 del naught. Whereas del naught is 9 by 4 del T. Actually, now this, if this value, if you see that del T, del naught value is greater to be, del T value is greater than. Sorry, del T is 4 by 9 del naught. Upper del naught enna? Del naught is lesser. Del T is greater. Del T is greater than del naught. Okay. Even though del T is greater than del naught, but del T is lesser than pyrene energy. So low spin complex. You have to keep in that mind. Del T is lesser than pyrene energy. So low spin complexes are very rarely observing tetrahedral complex. I make it very clear, sorry, confusion. Del T is equal to 4 by 9 del naught. That is the value being given. Prida, upper, my del T value is del naught value into 4 by 9. So del T is greater than del naught. Del T is greater than del naught. Understand? The splitting energy of del T is greater than del naught. Let's check. Even though del T is greater, it is nowhere later, but I am talking about the low spin. In tetrahedral complexes, it is very rarely to observe low spin complexes. Why? When a low spin complex, a high spin complex in tetrahedral, now I have to check with pyrene energy. Pyrene energy is higher than del T. So electrons should go to higher excitation state. So high spin complexes are mostly seen in tetrahedral complexes. Low spin complexes are very rarely observed. Pyrene is not easily readily taking place. That's the reason. I made the mistake here. Keep it noted. I'm not confused. Sorry for the confusion. Del T is equal to 4 by 9 del naught. 4 by 9 into del naught is del T value is larger. That's okay. That's okay. So see, that's all I'm saying. They will ask why complex formed by carbon monoxide is highly stable due to synergic effect or due to back bonding. அது நீ எழுதினாலே போதும். Explain synergic effect அப்படின்னா கேட்க மாட்டான். Don't worry. Asynergic effect எப்படின்னா, because actually metal bond is formed by when lone pair electron on carbon is donated to the vacant d orbital of the metal atom. Metal atom in turn donate their electron to the anti pi bonding of the carbonyl compound. So since there is a back bonding, a pi bonding is taking place between the atom, make it very stronger. That's the reason. And one more thing you should keep in mind, the spectrochemical series, have a look on the chemical spectrum just by heart, you can keep it. Sometimes they may ask you which is more stable. For example, that is a doubt I have also answered. We have told that EN is a diidentical. Greater than donor atoms, the complex form is more stable, V2. But CO is more stable because of back bonding, because of pi bond formation. ஆனா நடுல ஒரு cn மைனஸ் வந்தா வாட் யூ ரைட் இஸ் a monoidentity ligand diidentity ligand அப்ப மோர் தி நம்பர் ஆஃப் ligands இட் ஃபார்ம்ஸ் a chelating effect மோர் chelating effect மோர் ஸ்டேபிள் தி காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் அப்ப வி திங்க் தட் திஸ் இஸ் மோர் ஸ்டேபிள் பட் ஆக்சுவலி cn மைனஸ் இஸ் மோர் ஸ்டேபிள் the complex formed by cn is more stable because the logic what we are doing experimentally we have different factors because some other factors also play a vital role so read the complex read the spectrochemical series in a better way understand that you read it because we there are nearby ions are there means we can have a better idea if we buy it carbon monoxide we know is the strongest beta because no other complex shows the pi bonding so co is stable appa the last but mappadala comes en and cn is there doubt comes If I have H2O and this H2O comes later, see EN only will come. I know because it's a diidentity ligand, more stable than water. But if I take CN and this, again my mind goes chelating effect is more stable. CN will not, I will not think of. So better read the studies. That I want to tell you. That's all. Can any doubt from your side? Any doubt from your side? ma tell me ma hello I'm not able to hear ma any sorry yes. any doubt from your side
no ma
yes ma mike somebody is talking but I couldn't hear you
ma'am no doubts ma'am
no doubt others okay no doubt means study leave the class can you understand how to answer the questions have you got a clear idea
yes ma'am
did you find any question that is deal from the deleted portions some by the mistake it might be I thought I saw one question right now yeah I asked one reaction between I minus and MnO4 minus it was one question was there this is coming under chemical properties MnO4 it's a deleted portion So yeah, if there is some mistake is comes, you leave it. But I see to that the question is not being in the test paper is not being edited. I'll check it out. But I see to that that see this time your question paper is asked for the CBSE bifurcation with the pakka bifurcation. I check it out because typing has to be done. Let me do my typing. I check it out. That is maximum it satisfies. Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, can we get our corrected papers, ma'am?
Ganga, one paper I have sent, ma'am. One paper is still I am having. I will be little free only on Saturday.
Ma'am, no, ma'am. Like we got only the marks, ma'am. We didn't get that paper.
Paper, ah? Paper was not sent. You have not seen the paper, eh?
No, ma'am. Our corrected papers we are not able to
see. Hey, you, again, you have to see it in the Google Drive only. You check it out from Miss Chitra, Miss. No, she check it out from her.
Yes,
I have given the corrected paper. I have given the corrected paper. It is in I deleted because my phone is overloading. I deleted from my system. Check it out. She is having.
Yes, ma'am.
Otherwise, I will check it out. No. Wait. I am having. Otherwise, I will. If she is not sending, I will send. Wait a minute. I will, whether I am having or not, I am. I deleted because it's. Yes, I am having. Basha, I am having. Tarun Kumar, I am having. Yes, I am having everyone's. Everyone, check it with her. If she is not giving, I will give you. Yes, we can ask her. She might be available from the Google Drive. She will be giving. If she is not able to give, then I will give you the paper so that you have a look on that.
Yes, ma'am.
One is better. Okay, ma'am. Shall we wind up the class by today?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Try to take up the test seriously. Then we shall. Have you written the assignments? Check out the go for the assignments to go through it so that it will give a better idea. Amma, mostly Monday can't be the class because that the coming classes of revision also can't be Monday because some Zoom class difficulty is there. Either it will be on Tuesday or on Thursday, depending upon your availability. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.